morning. We're back again. Lovely morning out there. Mild right now. Gee whiz. What can you say? Canes. We're working on the canes. As you can see, I've got them pared down now to some reason. What I'm going to do now is just give them a little sand. Pad. I've actually got a proper sanding pad somewhere. I've got two of them somewhere. I don't know where they are. I think your son's got them. Must be using them. Anyway, but I do this type of thing. I put, I glue a bit of cardboard and glue sandpaper to it. And what it does is it's good for this, for not creating all spots on it. You can actually run it right back and forward along the length, and it saves you putting dips in. I'll need to go in and out back and forward on the plane here and there when I look at them, but this is just to take the work of the ridges off and out. You don't have to make. Someone said that looking at that other one, I maybe have to up my game a bit, like, you know, I maybe have to put a lot more time in. But with a pad you can get it at length over it. And I'll finish them eventually with wire wool. So just to let you see where we are. Lift things. This saves you dipping into holes and that. But the eyes of things, you do so much, and then if I'm working on it now, I can see one or two spots on it here and there. But you're going to get that because it's just the way it is. If you take your time in the finishing with this, you'll get it to where you want. Close enough anyway. But talking about that one yesterday, that ebony one yesterday and the other video, I was thinking about it. Maybe I walk in the afternoon, do my best thinking when I walk. I don't say best thinking, I do like thinking when I'm walking around. That's the beginning of ebony. That's been a fancy cane at one time. And when I came back and checked the antler, when I took the top of the antler, the handle part off, I knew, looking at it, it wasn't right anyway. It just wasn't what it should be. But when I came back and checked the antler handle, I went, oh, that wasn't on there originally. That antler belonged to something totally different. So it's been probably a fancy cane at one time. I would imagine there's been a bit of the ivory ball or something similar on top. Silver mount, probably a silver mount in it. Haven't seen one many years ago with something similar. I don't know why it didn't come to mind, but I should have clicked straight away when I noticed it was ebony. But it's probably been a ball type. Off when I've been a pretty swagger, not totally swagger thing, but that type of thing, in a mixture of in between. But I'm going to try and, I've had a word with it, so I'm going to try and replicate it a little bit. Not that I've not got that much, I've got a little bit of ivory, which I'll try and make up a mount. I've got enough there just to make a small ivory mount for the top of it. And then put a hardwood. I'll show you in a moment or two once I've got through this bit of it. And make up a different handle for it. They're nicer all together. It was never, and the ferrule part of it would probably have been a certain amount of silver on that too at one time. But it's all gone now. So, but very nice cane, very nice tank all together. It's been expensive. I think when it was bought. How old? Difficult to say. Very difficult to say. But maybe a good 80 to 100 years in it, I think. And the other one, the peak, it's extremely bit. We pass on it our original layer, they belong to it. And I will try and bring it back to its form of glory, bit by bit. Made me up my game a little bit, I think, in terms of the finish I'm looking for in these canes. We stand aside, I mean, they're not plywood, but this is a different type of, this will be a walking cane, a proper walking cane. These are more show than anybody, you know, for a walk on a, back then they were big on going to the park and dressing up and going out on a Sunday, walk around the park, that type of thing. I like that whole business. One day of the week, people got kind of dressed. Church in the morning and a walk in the afternoon. Anyway, that's the idea. The thing is to just, yeah, that's getting there bit by bit. Probably going with the plane a little bit here and there, probably just down in there a little bit. As you can see, it's taken a far better shape to it altogether. And a few more hours sanding and chewing it up at where it needs to be, it'll be fine. But yes, but these are good if you know, bit spare, cardboard, plywood, that kind of thing. But you get the proper ones with the handles on them, and they're very good. But this morning I'm saying, I'm lying about that too, but it's maybe in there somewhere. Right? But back to the ebony. I'll probably extend the dowel part of it just slightly. And say I've got a bit of ivory that I'll make a crown for it to sit. Oh, this was the other stuff that I was talking about. The fruit, the bowls of hardwood fruit. Well, I dug it out, it's all in there, everything's in there. But you can see this type of things. Some of it you'd maybe recognise an apple, a pear, I don't know, it's kind of exotic too, I think some of it, like, you know, but the nice shapes. This one in particular is a lovely shape. Really made for an op handle, that one. Very, very nice. That they've been lying about for years. And I'm just quite glad I'm getting around to actually using them. I get out of everything eventually, like, you know, right? But yeah, I can't keep a hold of all things just about, you know. But what type of fruit this is, I'm not really sure. Could be a banana, not big enough, well, maybe a small one. But this one's got a bit of shake on through it, it'd probably not do at all. But yeah, it's been lying in there for years, and we get around to using some of it. You know? But as I say, I've got the bit ivory there, and I'm going to try and make a little ivory mount for it, and to use probably this one, I would think. Sand, yeah, I think that'll work quite nicely. Sand it all down, and. Maybe a little bit of shape on it. Quite nice, I think. So that's that. But as I say, there's quite a while to go yet. In preparation. But I thought I'd just fill you in. I discovered this is one I made ages ago. Thing without brown trout. Supposed to be. Well, it will be eventually. When I get around to finishing it. But it was in amongst all the stuff there. I don't know what's in there at the time. Mind you, I've had a little bit of rain, so. But yeah, that's. But the timber are glued together. It's all right. You've got a chance. We'll give it a bit of time yet. Don't want to go into it too early. Give it plenty of time to harden off. That'll be that. But the other thing was, let's show you this. I got given this quite a few bits and pieces actually. Chap says, "Have you got a use for that?" I says, "Yeah, I've got a use for that." "What is it?" He says, I don't know. He says, "What do you think?" I says, "Like, difficulty trying to figure out where the bloody grain was in it actually, because it's so dense." But for the life of me, the only thing I could think it was is it's got marked on the back of it, USA only. So, but they couldn't give me any other information on it. Light, extremely dense. If it's grown in this, must be, the only thing I can think of is it's lindenwood. It's lime in our country, but the Americans didn't call it lindenwood. And I think it was used in the aircraft industry at some point. In fact, I think I'm led to believe that Howard Hughes, when he was building that Spruce Goose, that big seaplane that just flew in No More, the eccentric billionaire, I think it was a lot of limewood was used in the construction of that, but it got the name spruce obviously because there was a certain amount, I think it was easy. Spruce Goose sounds better than London Goose. Anyway, I thought I'll make good handles. I'll take it over to a chap that I know who's got a nice little bandsaw, and he'll slice one up first and see just how it. But for crook handles, yep, I don't think you need to laminate that at all. I think it'll probably work the way it is. Anyway, we'll leave it at that and we'll get back on the next one and that. But as I say, you can get away with dowel. A bit of dowel, put it on, and or sort it out before you do it, and you can actually just work away at it. Be block plane, good eye, plenty of time, sandpaper, and you'll get there. It'll certainly make a shank that's suitable, right? So that's it. Anyway, we'll pass at that, and we'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.